Thanks for joining me on this trip to Kununurra. The township of Kununurra was gazetted in 1960, and it's the youngest town in the East Kimberley. From its humble beginnings as a small settlement that catered for workers employed in the construction of the diversion dam, Kununurra today is a vibrant center that offers modern services, shopping facilities, an intense agricultural, mining, and tourism sector, a host of community activities, and a lifestyle that suits 6,000 people. We gradually approach northwestern Australia. The largest lake in Australia, Lake Argyle, will gradually appear, and to the north, about 150 kilometers, is the town of Kununurra. Kununurra is located on the Ord River. Below Kununurra is the Ord River Diversion Dam, quite a large dam backing up the river and used to generate hydroelectricity. The town is becoming visible now. It's not very high definition. Lake Argyle, constructed by a large dam in the 1960s and early 1970s, is the largest freshwater man-made lake in the southern hemisphere. Provides water for the Ord River Irrigation Scheme, which grows crops such as sugarcane, mangoes, and sandalwood. A picture of Lake Argyle. A Google snapshot of Kununurra with the diversion dam on the Ord River below it. The Kimberley scenery on both sides of Kununurra is outstanding. How could my traveling companion, Jamie Wright, speak to such scenery? A wedge-tailed eagle seen en route. The early settlers were the Aboriginals who occupied the land between 40 and 100,000 years ago. Kununurra was only begun in the early 1960s, shown here. It's surrounded by high hills with many vantage points. I stayed at Kununurra twice, both going to and coming back from Darwin. First stop was the Kimberleyland Holiday Park. We spent a week at the Corner Waters Holiday Park, located a bit out of town, but directly on the Ord River. It was excellent. This is the view inside the park gate. Jamie sets up the caravan. A fan palm. We camped underneath this tree in loving memory of Janine Weir, died at 26 years of age. No one seemed to know her. The view from the caravan, looking at the Ord River. You can even cook. Keep in mind it's situated next to the sign warning you not to feed the freshwater crocodiles and to take care if swimming. Limited liability. Jamie and I head into town. We pass the Ivanhoe Village Tourist Park, another caravan park on the Ord River. Ivanhoe Caravan Park is next to the Celebrity Tree Park, with all the trees dedicated to celebrities. A look at the park. John sits in the park in front of a boab tree, not dedicated to me, unfortunately. A group of Aboriginal women set up camp. We continue into town past the power station. 6 kilometres out of town on Paddlesack Road is the Zebra Rock Gallery, a unique striped rock found only in Kununurra. There's also a wildlife park there. Early houses in Kununurra were on stilts and constructed of fibro. Kununurra today looks a bit more modern. I love the bookshop cafe where you can have a cappuccino and look at the books. Here I am having a cappuccino. There are some magnificent photographs on the wall. There are lots of art galleries for tourists. A local building shows a boab tree. Some of the main streets of Kununurra. The Kununurra District High School caught my eye with these decorations of the three primary centers. There's lots of fishing in the region. We drop into the visitor center. We're feeling dry. Jamie and I decide to drop into the Hotel Kununurra, Jamie for a Guinness, an eye for a ginger beer. Jamie's tire is flat when we come out. Those double G's are wicked. We proceed back along the Ord River to the lagoon. This boat offers tourist trips and a barbecue down to the Ord River Diversion Dam at sunset. Once we figured out the ramp needs to be turned around, it was good for my wheelchair. The scenery from the boat is magnificent. And the barbecue is excellent too. They gave us the leftover meat, which fed us for a week. My traveling companions, Bill and Sue. The dam has flooded much of the old forest. That sign was not kidding about freshwater crocodiles. An egret? We reach the diversion dam, which is dammed up the Ord River. We cruise back and forth as the sun sets. The dam was constructed in the early 1960s. Its purpose was to provide irrigation waters for the Ord River Irrigation plant. Well, the sun has set and it's almost time to head back. My companion Jamie has been fishing while we cruised. The Ord River is a popular fishing area. Jamie gives up in disgust. All he caught was this turtle. which was released by my friend Richard, unharmed. The Argyle Dam was completed in 1972 and the land was cleared for irrigation. Many crops failed to thrive, including cotton. Crops that have, such as sugarcane, bananas and melons, are exported to Asia. The area is popular with backpackers, it's a place to pick fruit. Peanuts being grown. Cotton is one crop that failed to thrive and is no longer grown. Processing a cotton crop. Water has been provided for over 440 square kilometers of farmland, and the project provides hydroelectricity. Sugarcane is another crop that is not thriving. November 2007, West Australia's only sugar mill was closed down. Sugarcane being cut in the Ord River. A new industry is WA sandalwood, which is set to dominate world trade. Sandalwood is a wood that provides fragrance and appears like this. ...175 kilometers south of Kununurra is the Argyle Diamond Mine, producing one-third of the world's diamonds. Diamond exploration began in 1972, and the big discovery occurred at Smoke Creek, just downstream from the diamond mine today. Quite a range of industrial orange, yellow, champagne, cognac, white, and the very rare pink diamonds are produced. The mine was commenced in 1983 and began full production 1985. It's 2 kilometers by 1 kilometer in size, covers over 300 hectares, using state-of-the-art technology. There are 4-hour tours of the mine on a fly-in basis only, with tours through the processing plant and viewing and lunch afterwards. Thanks for joining me, Don, on this quick trip to the city of Kununurra in northwestern part of Western Australia. I do hope you have a good day.